Right, this is the second video I've had to record because for some reason the OBS defaulted to 640 by 480. So while you could get the general gist of it, all the controls and things I was clicking on were all blurry as heck. So here we go again, take two. So in the game, or in DR, I've got the original tunnels that are basically patch based, but you can see the problem. The textures are all stretched because in DR there's no way to apply a texture to a patch shape like this, or in this case multiple patches, and get the textures to line up. Now Dram, when he originally created these, he kind of cheated and got the textures to meet, so basically between there and there the texture would flip, so that you get that. It is kind of a scene, but it was a bit of a, it was a like a dirty workaround, as it were. So this is why I'm trying to do this all in Blender, so that the whole surface of the cave, the whole ceiling and walls, have one continuous texture. And the only way to do that on a model is in Blender. Now, obviously, I wanted to take it a step further, and I want to have Vertex Blended Floors, where the stone texture then blends into the sand floor texture. So that's what I'm here to show you today. So over here is the same thing but exported as a model, which I can then import into Blender. That model there was what the first video was done on, and I showed how I did it, but then this video should be a bit shorter because obviously I had to pause a few times trying to remember how to do stuff in Blender, which I won't have to do now for this video. So let's open up that model in Blender. Here it is already. It's already selected. The first thing you'll notice is these weird seams. This is because these are all individual patches, and that when Blender exported it, it doesn't export it as one continuous mesh slash model. So the workaround for that is you import the model, select it, so you've got the orange around the edges that you can see. And if I come out, you can see it. Look, it's got, it shows that it's selected. Then you select the whole, or you go into edit mode, select the whole model, which is A to select all. Then W to bring up the, I don't know what context menu this is. I have seen it. I think it's probably in mesh. Remove doubles, or is it under view? View? Select. Is it under faces? Can't remember where it is. But anyway, I learned this trick yesterday, which is W. Remove doubles, and now you can see it's one continuous mesh. Right, the next step is, while you've got these all selected, because it further down the line when we go into UV edit, when I go into the UV editor, it'll become apparent that a Blender can only work on quads for the most part. Most of its stuff is done on quads. It doesn't like working with tries or triangles. So let's just see if this will do this nicely, because this is basically just a tube. It's not curved per se, but it may still do, it may still convert or incorrectly convert the tries to quads. So mesh, unwrap, where is it? No, not there, sorry. Mesh, faces, tries to quads. Yeah, it's done it perfectly. Basically on the other model in here, for example, where is it? There. A bunch of them here didn't convert properly. And on this model, because it goes down, all the ones along there that were all facing diagonally out, that whole section of both sides of the mesh didn't convert properly to quad, so I had to manually convert them. But everything else that's on a flat surface, so the floor, the ceiling, and the perpendicular sides of the wall, they all convert to quads properly. But basically that corner where obviously the model goes down, I had to manually convert all the tries to quads. But in this instance, it did it all perfectly. So happy days. Right, let's open up another section to open up the UV editor. Right, next thing I'm going to do is just for purposes so that you can see what we're looking at. In the viewport, I'm going to go in, so click on nodes, changes the surface to diffuse, which obviously should ring a bell. The only bit that's confusing is on here, is like, how the hell do you, where do you open up the texture? It took me bloody ages to figure this out until Dragopher told me where it was. You click on that bloody dot, and then you click image texture, and then click open, and then it becomes obvious where you go, and then what the next steps are. Where is it? Boom. And now you can see the weird stretchy nonsense that we're going to correct in Blender. And now I'll select, go into here, and I might as well add this as well, just so you guys know how to do it. This is a custom texture that I created for my whip, and you'll probably recognize what BHM stands for. DDS, textures, dark mod, nature, dirt, and then sand. So that's basically a replication of what we've got. Here, same thing, basically. If we look at that model, it's got materials, yeah, it's got the both. It's got the blended for the floor, yep, and the rock for the walls, which is what we want. But basically normal, non-blended on the walls and the ceiling, and then the blended texture on the floor. But I'm going to take you through the steps on how we get the texture to line up. Basically, you can change the scaling of only the whole mesh, the texture scaling of the whole mesh. So the way to get the sand, which looked a bit stretched in game, is you change the scaling in the material def. So if we go in here and we go to sand, where is it? Sand, there it is. I've scaled it there. So basically this sand is at 2 times the scale of what is assigned to it in Blender. Right, let's go back to Blender. Right, so oops. Back to Blender. A, by the way, is it selects all, or if you've already got something selected like I just did accidentally, it deselects it. And then if I grab something and move it, you can just left click again after selecting it, and that'll revert what you just did. Right, so in this instance I want to select the whole thing, and I want to assign rock textures for now, because I want to resize it and I want to fix the UVs and make sure that the rock texture looks correct. So now what I'm going to do is, let's just see, because this is tube, I'm probably not going to have to do the second steps, but we'll see. Unwrap. No, it balked it. All right, fair enough. Well, that's easy enough. Right, so basically this is what you don't want. As you can see, it's all the texture is the right scale at one end, but at the other end of the tube, the scale is all broken. So if we go into game, look, you see it's all nice and sharp there, and it's all blurry at that end. So we don't want that. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go into wireframe mode. Now, you can pick the seam anywhere you like. I tend to pick the ceiling because players don't tend to look up that often. All I'm doing there is pressing Control, left click to drag select. And then I'm going to go into Mesh, Edges, Mark Seam. Now if I press A to deselect, you can see there's now a red line now where the seam is. So now if I press A to select all, go back into Material Mode, and then go, you don't have to go into Material Mode, this is just me showing you the change in game. So now when a change in the viewport editor, I should say, if I go Unwrap, boom, now it looks like it's supposed to, it looks better. It's still not perfect because the lines of the texture are all a bit curved, and you can see now on the ceiling where the seam is, textures aren't lining up. It all looks weird. So now what we're going to do is we're going to correct that by using a thing in Blender called follow active quads. Basically it's here. Okay, there it is. Follow active quads. But what we need to do is create a perfect quad that's perpendicular to the grid. So it's top to bottom, it's perpendicular with Y, perpendicular with X axes. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pick one. So deselect there. Now I always get this wrong because for some reason in UV Editor, in this version of Blender, it doesn't have the axes shown in the viewport. So I don't know what's going on there. Maybe there's a way to turn it on. So you have to play a guessing game. There's only two options. You'll either get it, you'll get it wrong the first time and then get it right the second time. So I'm pressing shift and then right click to select the verts. Then I'm going to go S for sizing. Then is it X? Yeah, X. So X in this instance is top to bottom. Then left click to deselect. And now you can see it's perpendicular. You can see the line's got no jaggies. Same thing again. S, X, and then 0 to snap it to perpendicular to that plane. Left click. Then A to deselect. Then select the two verts again. Now it's going to be S, then Y, as in these are the keys on the keyboard. So S for size, Y for the axes, 0 to snap it. Left click. Boom. Job you done. Oh. Now deselect. Shift select to do the thing, S, Y, 0, left click, and that's it. That's our active quad now. So what I'll do is A, again, select all, then I go back to mesh, UVmap, follow active quads, and this here we want to say even. We want all the quads to be the same size. Go okay. What's going on? Oh, I got this wrong in the last video as well. I think, oh, ignore that. That was me pressing S, the wrong key, and I was almost resized the whole bloody model, which we don't want to do because then it'll screw with the sizing in game. I think I have to press find the quad that's the one that I did the work on. So, no, is it that one? No. That one? No. Where is it? It's there. So it's next to the one I did. I think it's that one. No. Yeah, there it is. Right. So there's my active quad. So I have to select it on the model. So in the user perspective viewport, not the UV editor viewport. So now I've selected that. And then press A. Ah, you can see it's got that weird, whatever that means. I mean, I think that means that's the one that's selected. So that's the active quad. Or the face. UV unwrap, follow active quads, even, boom. There we go. Now the only problem here now is that the sizing is off. So what I need to do is resize this so it fits inside this gray grid. So what I'm gonna do is S and then X. G to move, S, Y, S, Y, S, Y, G to move it down, right, let's just S it to get it to fit, because what I'm trying to do, I still don't know the correct way to make the thing, the UV map, snap one-to-one with the selection grid in the UV editor window. So this is the workaround I found. In fact, something not quite right there. See that slant on the buff, the left and the right? That shouldn't be happening. So let's correct that. So it was SX 0. Now just unwrap it again. Maybe it'll bloody be perpendicular this time. Yeah, there we go. So clearly I balked getting all those lines have to be perpendicular. So the Y and the axis is to have to be, and that's why those lines there weren't the right size. Right, so I'm in that window. That's why I've just selected A. I'm going to go S, Y is it? No, so Y is to get it that way. S and X is to get it that way. Then the next one is Control P. And then I think that fits it to the, to the grid, and it did. Doesn't always work in the previous video. I know it didn't. There you go, look. So it's A to select, click on it, it's A to select all, G to move it up a bit. S, Y, Control P. Oh, no, fuck the. Now, be careful what you're bloody selecting on. Good old Blender. So complicated. Right, S, Y, Control P. Oh, I think that's it. Yep. Right. Now, I know the sizing in all the other models I've created is 2, so I'm going to increase that. But you can see now the seam is there, but you can't see the join in the texture. I mean, it all perfectly lines up. So I'm going to do that. Let's go into the UV editor, go S and 2, press enter, and now that's it. That's a 2 times texture sizing. So now what we're going to do is change the floor texture to use the blended texture. And you can see the floor texture looks all stretched and horrible. Well, that gets fixed in by the material that I think I showed you before. Yeah, where you just basically increase the scaling in the material def. Because I haven't figured out how to change the scaling independent in Blender. I mean, in fact, I don't think it would work because you would end up getting stuff, textures would line up. Right, next step then is to make sure that the model is smooth. Select all, go to object mode, select it, file. Oh, hang on, I've skipped a step. I need to go into vertex mode, vertex paint. And when you're doing vertex painting, you've got 2 colors, the vertex color and the inverse vertex color. Because most of the time, the only color that I want, the vertex color that I want on the floor is the invertex color. It's the darker of the 2 colors. It doesn't matter, but that's when the first guide I ever showed, this is basically what they did in that tutorial, and this is how I do it moving forward. Let's go into wireframe mode, and you can see where I'm painting, so that you make sure you're painting on the right quads. Right, just to zoom in a bit, that's the blended area there. So there's your stone, there's your sand, and that's the blended zone just there. You can choose where you want on your model to do this. I've chosen to do it just here where the sand goes up a little bit like it would in real life. And then obviously it blends into the wall. It basically, it's less harsh when you do it here, as opposed to doing it halfway up the wall. But you could do it halfway up the wall as well. So for example, if you were in a sewer and you want the dirt to go up the wall, you would have the blend up here instead. But in this instance, I've got it just on the floor area as well. Something else I explained in the other video, and actually I'll go back into DR and explain here, is the reason why I've got the blend texture only on the floor and not for the whole model, is because for some bizarre reason, the version of ID Tech 4 that we use in the dark mod can't blend bump maps. It only shows one bump map, even though in the material def there is two bump maps as per you're supposed to. Like, I don't know where it got broken or if it ever worked, but let me quickly show you. So there's, you got your bump map, diffuse map, bump. So there's your vertex color and then your inverse vertex color, and for some bizarre reason it only shows one of the textures. I think it's the first one it shows. So that one, for example, that bump map, it only shows the first one in the list. It doesn't show the second one. I've asked DRAM for help on this because I'd like to figure it out, but there is a bug tracker for it, but it's been a problem for years. So my workaround is I have the blend map on one mesh only, and then I have normal texture or stock TDM texture on the other. So that way I get the two different bump maps. The problem there is that you then have to manage where the blend is so that the different bump maps, it's not obvious where they are. Although there's a couple of screenshots on Discord where I clearly showed the delineation between the bump maps, and then it's obvious, but only if you're in an oblique angle or parallel to it and looking down the surface of the mesh that you can see it. But you could put objects in front of it to hide that. But for now, this is my workaround. Right, back to Blender. I've now done the painting. Yep, so let's go back to object mode, file, export, light wave. Make sure you select smoothed. Go into the model folder. And I think this is model 3. Yep. Boom. Now if we go in to DR and import that, reload that model. So it's already there. There we go. Now, I did think this is going to happen. I think I've increased the scale too much because that's such a small model. It's, the scale is all wrong. It's stretched everything. And by everything, I mean the floor and the ceiling. So what I'm probably going to have to do, and it's rotated it as well. So let me go back into Blender. Undo the texture sizing. Yeah, I might have gone too many steps, and I have. That's another problem with this version of Blender. There's not enough to undo steps. So what I'm probably gonna have to do now is resize it so it fits the square. So S. Control P to get it to fit, and I still think this is the wrong size, but let's leave it at 1:1 and see what happens. Let's just look for my, there's a chunk of rock, that bit there. There it is. So it's the whole little area is about the size of a quad. So let's see what that looks like in game, or in Blender. Yeah, I think it's stretched it, but we'll see. I might have to rotate the texture. Right, so deselect, vertex paint, wireframe. I think that's it. Current object mode, A, export. Yeah, right. I did mention this in the other video as well. Now, but I'll mention it here because this will obviously, you can clearly see that the texture has been rotated. This in itself isn't really a problem, but for continuity, I am going to rotate the texture. But in the main map, there are tunnel supports that act as a divider between the two tunnel sections, so it's not a problem. The other issue is, I forgot to assign the vertex blended texture to the floor, so you can clearly see that that doesn't look right in DR either. So let's go in there and quickly fix this. Edit mode, texture. Well, first of all, let's rotate the texture so that it lines up properly. Now, I'm in the UV editor, so I'm going to go R for rotate 90, and I should rotate the texture 90 degrees, and I've left clicked deselect the change, or to complete the change. Now, this might be the wrong rotation, so let's have a quick look at the wrong direction of the rotation. So, that looks like an obvious thing to look at in DR. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong bloody part of the map. Hang on. Right, there's a big line there and there's a thing there. So, or a crack in the rock. So, let's just see. Right, well, I either have to rotate it by 90 or rotate it by 180, but I think, yeah, that looks like part of the bit of the rock that was cracked, but well, we'll find out soon enough. Right, let's just quickly export that to see if I've rotated it the right way. I hit select, export, Lighto, tunnel 3. Yeah, this is something that I run into a lot. I forget the controls. I'm in Blender for ages, going to DR and then select. So, like A, escape is the equivalent of A, or to deselect in DR, and then obviously you click on the whole model to select it all again. And middle mouse click to rotate is Blender, and then left click and rotate is DR. I'm constantly having that happen to me. Anyway, reload selected model, and I've rotated it the wrong way. Okay. R180. Let's try that. Enter to complete, export. Well, the bit I'm interested in is this bit here. This is the one it needs to line up with, the model I've already worked on. So what is it that's neat? I think I need to increase the texture scaling. What I'm looking for is a bit of the texture that will line up. Which I think is that bit there lines up with that bit there. In fact, there's a cluster of rocks that I use as like a guide to see if the scaling is going to match. Yeah, and it looks like it's stretched. Stretched top to bottom, so I need to increase the scaling of the texture. Oh, that's annoying. So I think I need to be in one direction, it needs to be a certain size. I was hoping I wasn't going to have to do this, but I suppose it's a good learning, good tutorial moment. But you can see it's stretched top to bottom, as in from here to in this direction, not that direction. So I've got to figure out how to get it to line up. So yeah, and one of the many problems with doing stuff in two different editing programs. Right, so how do I do this? You know what, while I figure this out, rather than you guys painfully watching me trying to figure this out, I'm just going to pause the video. Right, this turned out to be a bit of a palaver. I did have to resize it two times, but then I had to shift it off to the bottom, as you can see. And then I had to slowly and painfully flip between Blender and Dark Gradient until eventually I got the bloody seams of the texture to line up. Let's quickly go into DR. There. So it's close enough that when you're far enough away from it, you're not going to see the join. But yeah, as I didn't have to go through this nonsense for that one and that one. They just lined up perfectly. So I'm probably going to have this nonsense for this one and that one as well. So we'll see. Right, so continuing on. Now that I've got the bloody texture aligned and facing the right way, I had to use basically, I had to rotate the thing 180 degrees and I had to mirror the texture as well, which I'm obviously not going to do now because I've got it almost perfect. So I'm going to leave it as is. The only step I've got now is go into vertex paint mode. Well, I think the next thing actually, let's just double check. Yeah, I haven't assigned the blend texture to the floor. Right, now going to paint mode. Oh, it's already painted. Okay, cool. Happy days. Right, go back out. Object. Export. Yeah, I'm going to spend an hour trying to fix that problem with the bloody texture misalignment. Happy days. And of course the sand isn't going to line up, is it? Because that would be too much to ask for. That's completely rotated. So that one and that one are good. Oh, so no, it lines up with that one okay. Ish. But obviously those are going to require fixing, so, well, let's have a look at it in game. Well, I can't see the bloody join. So where is it? It's there. Well, I think I did pretty well there. Ah, there you go. So from whichever, if you get down, so I'll just place a rock here and then you won't see that. Happy days. Right, I hope that made sense. And sorry about the gap, although for you it's been literally a second, but for me it's been an hour trying to figure out why stuff wouldn't line up properly. But yeah, bit of a palaver, but there you go. I hope this helps.